परतून एकदा येवकार. तुम्ही पळयतात अंतरिक्ष अप अप अँड अवे, आणि आज आम्ही हांगा आसात मेट्रोलॉजिकल डिपार्टमेंट जे आल्तीन आसा पणजेन. आणि मेट्रोलॉजी म्हणजे वेदर सायन्स, हे कशें, हे किदें, हे कशें हाजो अभ्यास करतात हे शिकपाचे आम्ही प्रयत्न करीत आसात. मेट्रोलॉजिकल डिपार्टमेंटाच्यो हांगा सायंटिस्ट मॅडम विशाखा दामले आमकां हो डिपार्टमेंटाचो टूर करीत आसात. तर परतून एकदा तांचे कडेन वचया आणि आमचो टूर कंटिन्यू करूया. आनी एक बरेंच टेक्निकल इंस्ट्रुमेंट दिसता मॅडम, वॉट इज दीस?
दीस इज कॉल्ड बॅरोग्राफ.
ओके.
इट मेजर्स दी प्रेशर ऑफ द डे ड्युरिंग ऑल द 24 hours. इन दॅट वन चार्ट इज सेट इन द अर्ली मॉर्निंग 8:30 अँड नेक्स्ट डे मॉर्निंग इट इज चेंज. सो इट मेजर्स इट इट ट्रॅक्स द प्रेशर ऑफ द एनी चेंज इन द प्रेशर ड्युरिंग द डे अँड इट गोज 24 hours रेकॉर्ड. अँड दीस इज बॅरो स्विच.
Okay.
When pressure is increased, this barrel switch is pressed.
Okay.
So this pointer goes down.
Okay.
And when pressure is decreased, barrel switch is expanding.
Uh-huh.
So this pointer goes up.
Okay.
So like that it gives the ink line.
Okay.
Whenever decrease or increase or continuous line it gives.
Okay.
So and shows the pressure value.
Okay.
Of the day.
Okay. Can we see one barograph, madam, which you already have?
Yeah,
yeah.
I can show you this.
Yeah. We will
barograph.
आमचो जो वेदर असा तो कसो चेंज जाता ते स्टडी करपाक हे सगळे जे इन्स्ट्रुमेंट्स मेट्रोलॉजिकल डिपार्टमेंटान आसात तांच्या मार्फत हे ग्राफ्स मेळटात. आनी हे ग्राफ्स एक इम्पॉर्टंट मिडियम आसा ज्यातून आमचे वेदर आमकां अंडरस्टँड जाता. आमी शिकपाक शकतात आमचे वेदर कशें आसा ते, कशें आमचें वातावरण आसा ते. मॅडम आमकां हे सगळे ग्राफ्स कितें आनी हांच्या बद्दल थोडेशें विज्ञान कितें आसा ते दाखयतली मॅडम. यू कॅन एक्सप्लेन सम ऑफ दीस.
दीज आर दी बॅरोग्राफ barographs.
Okay.
That is giving the pressure change during the day for all the 24 hours.
This is taken every day?
Every day. It is set in the morning 8:30 and removed next day morning 8:30.
Okay.
So it measures all the pressure value during the 24 hours.
Then so the next graph is?
This graph is also thermograph.
Okay.
It measures the temperature value throughout the day.
Okay.
For all the 24 hours. This is also set early morning 8:30 and removed next day morning 8:30.
Okay.
So it covers all the 24 hours of the day.
Okay.
It gives highest temperature of the day, lowest temperature of the day.
Okay.
And other values throughout the day.
Okay. Then the third graph is?
This is relative humidity graph.
Okay.
So it measures the relative humidity of the day.
Okay.
From morning 8:30 to next day morning 8:30.
Okay. Means how much moisture is there in the atmosphere?
Yeah, humidity of the atmosphere.
Okay. And the last chart is?
This chart is Rengage, self-recording Rengage chart.
Okay.
It measures rainfall fallen in the Rengage. Okay. During the day.
During monsoon?
During, if rain is there, then monsoon.
Okay.
Otherwise, other pre-monsoon, post-monsoon rain also we get.
Okay.
So it covers all the season.
Okay.
We have to put it throughout the year.
Yeah. मॅडम तुम्ही प्री मन्सून पोस्ट मन्सून असे म्हणले हे आम्ही टर्म सदां वाचतात पेपरात पण एक्झॅक्टली व्हॉट इज द मिनिंग ऑफ प्री मन्सून.
होल इयर इज डिवायडेड इन टू 4 सीझन. सो जानेवारी फेब्रुवारी इज द विंटर सीझन, कोल्ड सीझन. मार्च एप्रिल मे इज द प्री मन्सून सीझन. देन जून टू सप्टेंबर इज द मान्सून सीझन. अँड ऑक्टोबर नोव्हेंबर डिसेंबर इज द पोस्ट मान्सून सीझन. प्री मन्सून सीझन इज मोस्टली इट इज डेव्हलपिंग द क्लाउड्स and very important for the development of monsoon.
Okay.
So
pre monsoon affects the factors affect monsoon.
Monsoon.
Okay.
So good monsoon depends on the pre monsoon development.
Okay. Okay.
And post monsoon is very prone for the cyclone occurring.
Okay.
Or earthquake occurring.
Okay.
Like that it is.
So this natural disasters mostly occur in the post monsoon.
Post monsoon.
Okay. Okay. So you have to continuously watch them.
Watch. It is, that's why it is 24 hours watch.
Okay.
We are doing morning, evening, night duties for.
Okay.
That only.
Continuously you are monitoring the
yes.
planet's weather.
Yeah, environment changes.
Changes. Okay.
Yes.
आम्ही मेट्रोलॉजिकल डिपार्टमेंटाचे काळजान म्हणतात तसे हार्ट ऑफ मेट्रोलॉजिकल डिपार्टमेंट पाविल्ले आसात. हांगा असा मेन जो सगळे कंट्रोल करता कंप्युटर आणि कंप्युटराचे सगळी डेटा एनालाइज जाता आणि खूप किती किती काम जे तुमचे कडे पावतात फोरकास्ट ते सगळे हांगा एनालिसिस ताजे चालू असता.
दिस इज कंप्युटर कनेक्टेड विथ VPN सर्किट. सो व्हॉट एव्हर ऑब्झर्वेशन्स वी आर टेकिंग एव्हरी 3 hours अँड वी आर रिसिविंग सम बुलेटिन्स फ्रॉम मुंबई, दिल्ली, पुणे. अँड वी आर सेंडिंग सम बुलेटिन टू ऑल इंडिया रेडिओ, Doordarshan or press media.
Or telecasting.
Yeah, telecasting. So all these bulletins we are sending from this computer.
Okay.
So every 3 hours observation we are feeding in this.
Okay.
It is going to our Bombay supercomputer,
okay,
then Delhi computer.
Okay.
And from there it goes all over the world. So,
you are connected to the entire world?
Entire world. So, this is called World Meteorological Department.
Okay.
So,
it is Goa Meteorological Department, then India Meteorology,
India,
and now World Meteorology.
World Meteorology.
Okay.
So, that's why 23rd March we celebrate World Meteorological Day.
Okay. What is done on this day, madam?
On this day, all these meteorological instruments are kept for exhibition,
uh-huh,
and visitors are allowed to see it,
okay,
on any time of the day.
On which day this is?
23rd March.
23rd
every
March.
Year.
Every year. सो आता तर 23rd मार्च चुकून गेला, पाठी पावलो, आता पुढल्या वर्षा याद दौरात 23rd मार्च इज वर्ल्ड मेट्रोलॉजिकल डे असे सेलिब्रेट करतात. त्या दिसा हांगा गोंयचेच न्ही, ऑल ओवर द वर्ल्ड न्ही मॅडम, मेट्रोलॉजिकल डिपार्टमेंट्स ओपन दवरतात. तुम्ही हांगा येवचे, सगळ्यांनी जे आमचे प्रोग्राम पळयतात, विज्ञान शिकपाक ज्यांका आवड असा त्यांनी मुद्दाम येवचे आणि हांगा सगळे पळोवचे. हे सगळे जे इम्पॉर्टंट इन्स्ट्रुमेंट असा जे आमकां सांगतात की आम्ही ज्या वातावरणात राहतात ते वातावरण म्हणलं किती ते अंडरस्टँड करपाक आमकां हेल्प करतात. हे तुम्ही अंडरस्टँड करात. 23rd मार्च तुमच्या मोबायलाचेर, तुमचे जे मोबायलात डायरी असा ते नोट करून रिमाइंडर घालून आजच दवरात. इट इज नॉट ओनली मन्सून, मेट्रोलॉजिकल डिपार्टमेंट ऑल्सो मॉनिटर सन.
सन, या.
ओके.
सो फ्रॉम दॅट वी कॅन, दॅट इज दॅट पॅरामीटर, दॅट सोलार रेडिएशन पॅरामीटर आर व्हेरी इम्पॉर्टंट फॉर फोरकास्टिंग ऑफ द
monsoon.
Okay. That is considered.
Because it is because of the sun that we,
yes,
get monsoon.
We get
monsoon.
Evaporation also is because of monsoon. Cloud formation also is because of vapor.
Monsoon.
So everything depends on the energy what we receive from the sun, and that is utilized by the atmosphere.
मॅडम, यू जस्ट टॉक्ड अबाउट क्लाउड फॉर्मेशन. आता जे क्लाउड फॉर्मेशन असा ते एक खूप इम्पॉर्टंट फॅक्टर असा विच इन्फ्लुएन्सस मन्सून. आणि मला दिसना की क्लाउड स्टडी करपाक काही मशीन असा म्हणून. सो क्लाउड फॉर्मेशन कसे मॅडम तुम्ही स्टडी करतात?
दॅट इज बाय visual judgment only.
By looking?
Yeah. So there are 3 types of clouds.
Okay.
High clouds, medium cloud and low clouds.
Okay.
High clouds are very high in the sky.
Mm.
So for that specific base is not there. For high clouds they go on developing with high in the air.
Okay.
So for that base,
yeah,
which we see near sea,
okay,
like that.
Okay.
Because on sea vapor is high.
High.
So from there the cloud development starts.
Okay. High cloud,
so
development starts from
seas.
Okay.
Means with water vapor content,
okay,
it starts. So it goes high up in the air.
Okay.
And as it goes on developing, its weight is increased.
Okay.
So as we go up, pressure is very less. And when this heavy cloud go up, they cannot stay in the atmosphere high,
okay,
enough.
Okay.
So they start coming down.
Down.
So from down also, vapor is going up,
yeah,
clouds are coming down.
Okay.
So these clouds are very well developed.
Okay.
So they are converted into low clouds.
Low clouds.
Low clouds. And when they come very high in the this lower temperature,
okay,
so these clouds are giving rain.
Okay. So they become the rain-giving clouds.
Rain-giving clouds.
Okay, okay.
High clouds are not giving rain,
okay,
but low clouds they give
rain.
At certain intensity they give,
okay,
rain.
If you're outside and look up at the sky, the chances are you're going to see clouds. And did you know all those different types of clouds have got different names? But how do you tell one from another? And how are they formed in the first place? In this film, we're going to answer those 2 questions and show you how to spot some for yourself. All clouds form in the same way. How high they are in the sky and the conditions up there will determine what the cloud looks like. It all starts when heat energy causes water molecules from rivers, ponds, lakes or oceans to evaporate into the air. This moist air rises and expands as it gets higher into the atmosphere, where the pressure is lower than down here. As the air rises, it cools, changing into very small water droplets that form into clouds. But the conditions have got to be spot on. The temperature's got to be right, and there's got to be something for the water to hold onto, such as particles of dust, salt or smoke. If neither of these conditions is right, then the cloud just won't form. Once the water droplets are big enough, they fall to earth as rain, back into oceans, lakes, rivers and ponds, and the whole cycle starts again. Although all clouds start in the same way, there are a number of factors that will determine what they look like and what sort of weather they'll bring. There are 3 basic types of cloud. Stratus, Cumulus and Cirrus. Stratus is a particularly featureless cloud. Fog, for example, is stratus on the ground. It's normally associated with coasts and mountains and is one of the lowest forming clouds. Bringing with it dampness and drizzle, it's a pretty miserable thing. Cumulus are one of the commonest clouds. They're the ones that form on sunny days with flat bottoms and tops that look like cauliflowers. They normally form over land and are known as fair weather clouds, but beware, some cumulus can develop into threatening thunderstorms with sudden downpours. So if you see these guys before midday, be prepared for some rain. There's a nice little rhyme you can help remember this with. In the morning, mountains, in the afternoon, fountains. The final type of cloud to look out for is cirrus. They're the highest forming cloud in our atmosphere. The word cirrus is Latin for lock of hair, and these are the clouds that cover the sky with wispy threads. But why do they look like this? Why aren't they puffy like normal clouds? Well, high up there it's so cold that cirrus clouds are formed from ice crystals rather than water droplets. As the ice forms, it falls to earth and is whipped up by really strong winds, and the clouds fall in streaks. They look like they're not moving at all, but of all clouds, cirrus move the fastest. They're also really useful for telling that there may be a change in the weather to come. So if you see cirrus clouds, be prepared for a possible storm. When you look up at the sky, you're not just going to see one cloud by itself, but normally many different types of cloud all at the same time. Stratus, cumulus, and cirrus are the three main types, but in reality, there are loads of different sorts of clouds to spot. So next time you're out and about, look up in the sky and see what you can find.
आयच्या ह्या प्रोग्रामात आम्ही ॲस्ट्रॉनॉमीचो एक ब्रांच ज्याका मेट्रोलॉजी म्हणतात ते कवर करपाचो प्रयत्न केलो. थोडीशी माहिती तुमच्याकडे दिवपाचो एक यत्न केलो. तुमच्या हाज्याबद्दल किती मत असत हे सगळे सकल हांगा आमची ईमेल आय डी असा ताजेर तुम्ही मेल करात आणि तुमचो फीडबॅक ताजेर काम करपाचे हांव प्रयत्न करतां. सजेशन्सूय हेच आमच्या ईमेल आय डीचेर दीत रावात. हांगा आल्तिनो मेट्रोलॉजिकल डिपार्टमेंटाचो एक टूर, तातूंत कितें इन्स्ट्रुमेंट आसात, ते कशें फंक्शन करतात, कशें कशें हांगा स्टडीज जातात, कशें कशें वेदर प्रेडिक्शन जाता, हें सगळें आमी फुडल्या एपिसोडांत पळयतले. पळयत रावात अंतरिक्ष अप अप एंड अवे, ओन्ली ऑन प्रुडंट मिडिया.